Hopefully by now you've seen our video on what Graham's number is. If you haven't, it's the number of dimensions that a cube must exist in before a certain configuration of coloured lines between its vertices must exist. Now this number is famously very, very big. How big is it? Well, we're going to let the man who first wrapped his head around it, Ron Graham, explain it to you.
Well, I can't really write it yet. I have to explain the notation. Okay, so we need some notation. So-called arrow notation, and often attributed to Don Knuth, computer scientist at Stanford. He's very creative about notation. And the notation is this. So suppose you write three arrows n. That just stands for 3 to the power n. Okay, so 3 arrows 10 is 3 to the 10th power. That's a pretty big number. Okay, so that's why do you need arrows to write 3 to the n? Well, you don't. Okay. Well, what do you mean by 3, 2 arrows n? Well, what that means is 3 to the arrow of 3 to the arrow of 3 to the arrow of dot 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 3 to the arrow of 3, and there are n threes. So what does this mean? 3 to the arrow of 3 is what? Well, it's 3 to the 3. 3 to that arrow is 3 to the 3. 3 to that arrow is 3 to the 3. So it's a tower of 3 to the 3 to the 3 to the 3, there are n threes. So, for example, 3 double arrows, 3. How much is that? Well, that's 3 single arrow, 3 single arrow, 3. Well, 3 to the 3, this is 3. 3 to the 3 is 27. 3 to 27, which is 3 to the 27, or 3 to the 3 to the 3. 3 to the 27th power is a pretty big number.
I think it's worth stopping here for just a moment to let things start sinking in. Two threes with one arrow between it. That's 27. Put two arrows between them and things escalate to up over 7 trillion. That's a pretty quick escalation. What happens if we use three arrows?
So this is 3 double arrow of 3 double arrow of 3. What is 3 double arrows 3? Well, it's 3 to the 3 to the 3, okay, 3 to the 27th. So this is 3 double arrows of anything is 3 to the 3 to the 3 to the 3 to the 3, and how many? 3 to the 27. 3 to the 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 27th power. Well, that's getting to be a pretty big number.
Yeah, I think that's an understatement.
So 3 arrows has given us a number so big, I can't even write it on the screen, except maybe like this.
Okay, so now I think we ran out of this piece of paper, actually.
You want some more?
Yeah, I think we...
All right.
You ain't seen nothing yet. Okay, so here we go, 3, 4 arrows. One more arrow. Well, what does this mean? 3 arrows of 3 arrows of 3. Well, this is 3 triple arrow of something. What is this number? Well, we just saw this number. That's right here, right? This is 3 to the 3 to the 3 to the 3 to the 3. Well, okay. So what does 3 triple arrow of anything mean? It's 3 double arrows of 3 double arrows of 3 double arrows of, finally at the end, 3 double arrows, 3. And how many 3s? This many 3s. So it's a pretty big number. This is 3 to the 3, 3 to the 27th. And this is a tower of that high, 3 to the 3 to the 3. That's this 3 to that. And then the next one is a tower of that height. And the next one is a tower of that height. And you repeat this for 3 to the 3 to the 3 to the 3 to the 27th time. So there's that many layers. Each one tells you the number of 3s in the layer below.
Now, 4 arrows has given us a number so big that mere mortals like us shouldn't even bother trying to imagine it. You can see I've just used the term insane number. And by the way, We're not even in the ballpark of Graham's number yet.
Now, what is this final number we're looking at? This so-called Graham's number? It's a 3, 4 arrows, 3. That's a big number. But what it represents is the number of arrows between these two threes. Remember, each additional arrow puts you into a much bigger world. Well, now, how many arrows do you have? Well, this many, but that's a big number.
So I hope you grasp that adding just one arrow takes things up by a crazy amount. Now we've got two threes, and the number of arrows between them is the insane number that I couldn't even write down. And that's the number of arrows. But that's not it. Once you take that three insane arrow three number, you spit out another number at the end that I don't even want to think about that one. You then take that number, and now that's the number of arrows between the threes. And then you repeat that again, and again, and again.
And each number tells you how many arrows are in the thing just below it. And you keep this process up, each one telling you how many arrows, 64 levels. That's the definition of this Graham number. So already to understand 3, 4 arrows, 3 is not so easy. But when you say that's how many arrows are in this number, and then that number is how many arrows in the one and so forth, it's, I think it's unlikely anyone will know the leading digit of this number. The last digit you can actually get, the last, I think there's a list, the last 500 digits you can, because it turns out you take a big enough power of three, the last digits, you know, are very predictable. But the first digit, I don't know. And
it's your number. What do you want it to, the first digit to be?
Well, in binary, it's one. So there you go.
So there we go, Graham's number. And if you think you understand it, you probably don't. And this is the upper bound on the number of dimensions that a cube lives in to force this configuration of lines between vertices. You can see the other video to have it explained. It's the upper bound. Now, we know it doesn't work in 12 dimensions, but it could work in 13 dimensions.
Could be, yeah, could be 13.
But it's
yeah.
Definitely less than that.
Definitely less than that, yeah. So it's called a small gap in our knowledge.
Somewhere between 13 and Graham's number. Now, Graham's number was once in the Guinness Book of Records as the biggest number ever used in a sort of constructive proof. It's since been surpassed by other mathematicians. But Graham's number was the first of these big boys, and it's still got that bit of glamour involved with it. If you'd like to find out more about the number, check out our original video from a couple of years ago, Ron Graham explaining what Graham's number is, and also some extra footage from Ron Graham that ended up on my virtual cutting room floor. You can check them out. There are links on the screen and underneath. And thanks a lot to Ron Graham for telling us all about Graham's number.